Hello friends, I am Sanjay Gupta. In this video, I am going to demonstrate you how you can implement simple calculator in Java. So for implementation of calculator in Java, first we have to import scanner class that is available in util package. This scanner class is required to read input from user. Then I am going to define a user defined class whose name is Kelsey. Inside this class, I am going to define main method. Inside this main method, logic for calculator for performing addition, subtraction, multiplication, and division will be implemented. So I am declaring three variables, n1, n2, and n3. Now I am going to create instance of scanner class. I am passing system.in as constructor. This system.in is responsible for deciding input location. So our input location is the console. Now, with the help of this system.out.println, the message enter first number will be displayed on output screen. To read that number, this input.nextint statement will be executed. So nextint is a predefined method which is available in scanner class. Now to read second number, I am pasting these statements and modifying them. So this way, two numbers will be provided by the user. First will be stored in N1, second will be stored inside N2. Now I have to display possible operations to the user so that user can enter a particular choice. So again, I am using system.out.println. Choices are. So here we have total four choices. First is addition. Second is subtraction. Third one is multiplication. Fourth one is division. Then again a message which will say enter your choice. So here user will be entering a particular choice. So I am going to store that choice into ch variable. So ch equals to input dot nextint. So choice will be available inside ch variable. Now I am going to apply a switch statement to check what choice has been entered by the user. Now inside this switch, I am going to implement various cases. So if user enters 1, this case 1 will be executed. So it will calculate addition, and through this system.out.println I can print addition equals to n3 and then break. Break is required if you want to execute a particular case. After implementation of case 1, I can copy paste it 3 times. So this will be case 2. Here subtraction will be performed. Then case 3, multiplication, then case 4, division. So this way total 4 cases are implemented. At last, default. If user enters a particular choice other than 1, 2, 3, 4, then default will be executed automatically. So here we can print the message, you have entered wrong choice. So this way I have implemented the complete code in front of you with the help of switch statement. Now I'm going to save this code. Name of file is calci.java and it is saved in D drive, inside D drive Java folder. Now I am opening command prompt so that I can execute this Java code. So I am moving to D drive, then in Java folder. So in D Java folder, calci.java file is available. Now I am going to execute this code. Sorry, I am going to compile this code with the help of Java C, calci.java. So you can see it is compiled successfully. There is no error. Now with the help of Java calci command, I can execute this code. It is asking for two numbers. I am entering 4 and 6. Now you can see it is asking for a particular choice. So I am entering 1. So it is showing addition equals to 10. So case 1 is working properly. Now let's check any other case. So for that purpose, I need to execute this code once again. So again, it is asking for two numbers. I am entering 3, 4. It is asking for choice. I am entering 3. You can see the multiplication equals to 12 is printed. Because choice is 3, that's why it is calculating multiplication. So this way code is working properly. Let's check default case. I am entering two numbers and choice I am entering as 7. So you can see it is showing you have entered wrong choice. So this way code is working properly in all the cases. In this way I have implemented a simple calculator with the help of switch. You can add as many features as required in your logic with the following scenario which I have demonstrated you. So you can put many scenarios with the help of switch and case in Java program. I hope you have understood how we can implement different scenarios in a single code in Java. Thank you for watching this video.